Mr. Excel Podcast is sponsored by Easy Excel. Learn Excel from Mr. Excel Podcast, episode 1917, Formula to Detect Crossout, or really any Excel formatting. Hey, welcome back to the Mr. Excel Netcast. I'm Bill Jelen. Back in episode 1538, I showed how to use conditional formatting to add diagonal borders to make it appear that we had crossed out a cell. And Ahmed just posted a question. And Ahmed just posted a question and response to that video where he wants to go the opposite way. So if he would cross out a cell, like for example A1, then another cell, cell B1, would change to the message to say target accomplished. So the question, is there any kind of a function that we can use like equal crossed out or equal is crossed out to detect the formula in another cell? No, there's not. And so I went back to Ahmed. I said, the only way we're going to be able to do this is with some VBA, and even then, it's not going to be perfect. He says, hey, yeah, VBA is fine. I've never done it, so walk me through it. All right, so here, a couple of things. Podcast 1917.xlsx, this is the default file format. This is a horrible file format because it's the only file format in the entire world that does not allow macros. So first thing, file, save as. We're going to save this to the exact same spot, but we're going to change the save as type from xlsx to anything else, xlsm, xlsb, even xls. Why they make this be the default, it is so horribly frustrating. If you do not do that, this process will not work, so don't skip that step. Next, we have to change your macro security. The way that I do this is Alt T for Tom. See right here, we get Alt T, and then M for Mary, and then S for Sam. That will take us to the Trust Center. There is another way to get here. It is horribly long. By default, you have disabled all macros with notification. That means that macros will not run in your Excel. Change it to this one, so that way the macros will run. All right, those few steps are very important. Now, we're going to write our own function in VBA, so you're going to press Alt F11. Never used VBA before, you're going to have just this big, ugly screen. Come here to View, Project Explorer, or press Control R, and then find your file. Here's my file. I'm going to click in that file and say insert a module. All right, now this is where we can write our custom function. I'm not going to ask you to sit there and watch me type everything because I'm a slow typer. I had this already on the clipboard. So we start out with the word function. That tells Excel that this is a custom function that's going to return a value to the spreadsheet. The name of the function is crossed out, and we're passing it a cell. So my cell is the variable name that I'm going to use in this function to figure out what's going on with that cell. I turn on application.volatile, but that still, I'll explain this later, is not going to make our life easier. If you're watching this video and you need to detect bold or italic or underline, you would use these lines of code instead, but we're looking for a crossout. So with a crossout, it's one of two things. Either they did the XL diagonal down or the XL diagonal up, one of those two, or maybe they just use Strikethrough, Control 5. All right, so these three things are checking to see if the cell that we are referring to in this formula has the diagonal down, the diagonal up, or Strikethrough. The OR operator out here combines all three of these. This is a continuation character. Don't forget the space before the underscore. It will not work if you don't type the space before the underscore. All right, so if any of these things are true, then the function name is crossed out is going to return the word target accomplished. Otherwise, it's going to return nothing. Quote, quote, end if to end that little section there, and then end function. All right, so we come back to our spreadsheet and we use equal is crossed out of this cell. And because that cell is not crossed out, we should get nothing. But when I copy that formula down to all of these other ones, it returns target accomplished. Isn't that amazing? We just added a brand new function to Excel that is actually looking at formatting, something that none of Excel's functions currently do. Now, here is the one horribly frustrating thing about Excel. If we type in the number 123 and we press Enter, they recalculate the entire worksheet. But if we go to that 123 and we do any formatting, Control B, Control U, Control I, Control 5 to strike through, that does not cause Excel to calculate the worksheet. So that means that these functions that we wrote up here, even though I said application.volatile, will not recalculate if the only change we made is a formatting change. So I'm going to come here and do Control 5 to cross that out, and you see that the function does not update. Now, in order to get that function update, we either have to press the F9 key to force a calculation, or we just have to come to any other cell and enter a number, which will cause everything to refresh. That's a little annoying that we have to do that, but if you understand, you know, the logic behind it, we need to be able to format a spreadsheet without having a recalc happen. Just imagine if you had a spreadsheet that took 40 seconds to recalc, they hadn't used Fast Excel from Charles Williams to make it faster, and then every time you did bold or, you know, underline, it would take 40 seconds. That would be horrible. So they let us do all the formatting changes without running the calculation. When you have crossed everything out and you need to calculate, just press the F9 key and you'll be good to go. All right, so I'm going to save this file and then File, Close. And then when I reopen that file, the next time you open this file, you should get either this security notice or a security notice right here above the spreadsheet, and you have to choose Enable Macros. That was our macro security setting that says we're going to disable the macros, but with notification that allows you to turn the macros back on. You know, we wrote this macro, so therefore you know that it's safe and you would enable macros. But if you get you know, emails from your competitor and it has a macro, yeah, then maybe you don't enable the macros. All right, so that's the whole idea there. All right, so I want to thank Ahmed for sending that question in. This obviously can be modified to handle any kind of formatting, and the trick is going to be for you to figure out what formatting you're checking for. Let's just say that you wanted to check to see if the cell had been colored a certain shade of red. You know, for example, we wanted to find any cells that had that red fill. In order to get that code, here's what I would do. I would go to the View tab, and I would go to Macros and Record a Macro, and you can just call it Macro 3, but I'm going to say How to Color Red, and I'm never going to run this macro. I'm just going to use the macro recorder to learn what the code is, and then come back here to the Home tab and choose the red that I'm looking for, and then down here next to Ready, Stop Recording, Alt F8 to get a list of my macros, and where was it? It was How to Color Red. I click Edit, and I see that they did selection.interior.color is equal to 255. This width is saying that we're doing selection.interior for each of these. The color.255 is a really important one, so color equal 255. So my code in the other one would become if selection.interior.color equals 255, then, and so I'm going to just copy that, Control C. Come back to my module here and paste that in. All right, so now this macro here, I'm going to actually just comment that out. This macro becomes now something that's checking for a fill color of 255. So no matter what kind of formatting you're looking for, by using that recorded macro trick, you can at least figure out, you know, what the code is. And we're actually going to throw this one away. It was just a little trick to figure out what code we needed to use to put in that function right there. All right, so an interesting question from Ahmed. This will sort of work, provided you're willing to press the F9 key. All right, well, hey, I want to thank everyone for stopping by. I want to thank Ahmed for sending that question in. See you next time for another netcast from Mr. Excel.